The Appalachian Wireless 30th Anniversary Holiday Sale is going on now. From now until the end of the year, visit us in store or reserve online for an unbelievable sale and giveaway. We know what you want for the holidays because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Fire safety is always an important topic, but especially during this time of year. With holiday decorations and colder temperatures outside, it can be easy to get carried away trying to decorate or keep warm. Earlier, we caught up with Nick Fleming of the Pikeville City Fire Department for some general tips on how to make sure you and your family keep fire safe this holiday season.
With decorating our home, the biggest thing is to make sure we go through our lights, making sure that they are in good condition. Also to make sure that those lights are meant to be used either indoor or outdoor, so check that. If the decorations are getting a little bit of age to them, or if the wires are cracked or anything like that, we probably want to go ahead and replace them. Another thing is don't overload your circuitry. So don't overload your outlet. Don't plug too many in one power strip as well, because that's a lot of times our issues that we have. Some tips on Christmas tree safety. We want to make sure that we are using the appropriate lighting and that we do check it just like with any other decorations. But also, just a reminder, 1/3 of every house fire, you know, during the winter time is caused by improper use of decorations. So it's an electrical type fire. So we want to make sure that we are keeping our tree lit properly, not overloading our circuits. Also with live trees, one thing we need to be concerned with is if it's too dry. So just make sure you water it or check it daily, make sure it doesn't dry out, because that can be a major problem. Usually if we have any kind of fires with a live tree, it's usually a serious one. Just try to keep your trees also away from any exits. That way if you had a fire, you'd be able to still safely exit the home. And just always have a plan in case there is a fire. That's the biggest thing, is always make a plan what to do if there is a fire in the home and practice it.
Fleming also had some additional fire safety tips for those who may use non-electrical heat sources in their homes.
So when we're trying to keep our home warm in the wintertime, the biggest thing is if we're using fuel heat like kerosene and things like that, we want to have it ventilated. So propane and kerosene is safe to use on the side of the home as long as we keep the area ventilated. So we want to keep some windows cracked to at least allow some fresh airflow. I would strongly recommend a carbon monoxide detector if you're using that type of heat. It's always good practice. Just let you know, hey, you know, it is a odorless and an odorless gas, so we don't really detect it with our nose. It's important to have a carbon monoxide detector. Also, we want to keep any heat sources, whether it be gas or electric, we want to keep that away from any curtains or any flammables. So it's always good to keep it 3 feet away from anything that might combust.
For Mountaintop News, I'm Joshua Sloan.